Siri is Apple's all-knowing voice assistant that can do at least 6 things. But Siri's biggest problem is that it activates all the time, whether you want it to or not.
Here's like, what I found.
Oh my god. So you can stop Siri from activating all the time, unprovoked, and the biggest offender of this is the Apple Watch. Anytime you have your wrist raised, it's listening for a command, even if you don't say, "Hey Siri," even if you don't say Siri at all. So to stop this from happening, open your iPhone, open the Watch app, tap Siri, and turn off Raise to Speak. For good measure, you can also turn off Listen for Hey Siri. And if you have bigger wrists than me and you find yourself pressing the button in all the time by accident, turn off Press Digital Crown. Now keep in mind that if you turn all three of these off, you won't be able to access Siri on your watch at all. That might be a plus. The next worst offender is, of course, your iPhone itself. So you'll go back to Settings and tap Siri in Search. Now, turning off Allow Siri when locked will eliminate most of the most annoying activations when you're not even looking at or using your phone. This way, Siri will only activate when you've got it unlocked and you're holding it in your hand. You can also adjust whether it listens for Siri, Hey Siri, or just turn it off entirely. And you can turn off whether pressing the side button activates Siri. Next, there's Siri on the Mac. Open System Settings, click Siri in Spotlight, and you can just hit the big toggle on the top, or you can separately turn off the keyboard shortcut or the automatic listen feature. Next, you want to click on Control Center, scroll all the way down, and you'll want to turn off Siri from the menu bar. Next up is Siri on your AirPods. This is activated by either tapping them or clicking them. With your AirPods connected, then you can adjust the left and right AirPod control, whether you want it to play or pause, skip forward or next track, or, crucially, whether it activates Siri. They can both do the same thing, they can both do different things. It's up to you. Next up is the Apple TV, which annoyingly places the Siri button on the side of the remote, exactly where you would go to pick it up. If you want to turn this off, you can go to Settings, General, Siri, and turn it off from here. If you're interested in a more traditional TV remote for your Apple TV, we have some for sale on the Cult of Mac store. Last and definitely least is Siri on the HomePod. Now, Siri is the primary way of interacting with the HomePod, so keep in mind that if you go through with this, you'll have to push the button on the top, or you'll have to AirPlay stuff from your iPhone to your HomePod going forwards. But if this is something you really want to do, you can just say, "Hey Siri, turn off Siri," and you'll have to confirm, and then Siri is gone forever, and this cannot be undone. No, not really. You can just push the button and say, "Hey Siri, turn on Siri," if you want it back again. So that's how you turn off Siri on all your Apple devices. If you're interested in rekindling your love with Siri, I have a video on all several things Siri can do. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.